guys. The 2018-2019 Broly movie just came out today. And for those of you that didn't see it, I just wanted to tell some of you a few things of what to expect whenever you do get to see it. I saw it about a week or two ago, and overall it was pretty good, but I wanted to just kind of give you a heads up. Okay, number one, there's always fans that are coming out with YouTube videos that tell you what to expect or what's going on whenever a movie like this is about to come out, and they try to give you some information on it that's completely off. I want to clear up two of those right now. Number one, there's a video out there where some user was like, oh, these are Broly's 5 forms for the movie. Broly doesn't have 5 forms in the movie. He has his base form, this kind of, I guess you could say, newer form that explains the green and his transformations, and then his Super Saiyan form, and that's it. The other rumor that I heard from one of my best friends, actually, was that it goes back into the story of Goku and Broly, like their origins, and it says that, well, he said that Broly is really Goku's brother and Raditz really wasn't. Okay, that's completely out too. Okay. Now, I'm not completely sure if the movie is going to be considered canon or not, but there are some other movies that are linked into it. Unfortunately, Tarball, Vegeta's younger brother, is connected to this. He's only mentioned in passing, but unfortunately that makes that movie, I guess you could say, a previous one to this one that they're actually counting as happening. Speaking of canon and all that, unfortunately the Broly movie is also subject to the treatment that Akira Toriyama gave Dragon Ball Super. And what I mean by that is completely retconning a bunch of already established facts. I mean, he does it so much in Dragon Ball Super that I pretty much dubbed it Akira Toriyama retcons everything. But it not only changes the origin of Goku and Broly, you know, meeting and everything, it also changes Bardock's story too. Now, I'm not going to give away big spoiler points to the movie and say what happens and things like that, but these are, I guess you could say, soft semi-spoilers. For one, they changed Bardock's origin story. He no longer gets attacked by a psychic warrior on a planet so that he can foresee the fate of Vegeta being destroyed by Frieza. For some reason, also, Bardock cares about Goku now. Like, in the Bardock movie, whenever Goku is first seen by Bardock, Bardock's actually pretty disappointed with him because of his low power level. That's not the case in this. Goku's mom is also in it for the first time on screen. Whenever Goku is sent to Earth, he's also not a baby when they send him to Earth. He's, for whatever reason, a toddler, like, before he can speak, but he's a toddler that can walk and is given Saiyan armor whenever he's sent off to Earth. And Bardock is actually the one that sends him to Earth and not, you know, the Saiyans themselves saying, oh, we gotta send Goku or Kakarot to Earth. Broly's origins are changed too. Broly is never actually even in the same room, I think, with Goku. Broly is actually sent off to a planet, one that's got very little life on it, very barren, and he's expected to die because, kind of like with the original Broly movie, King Vegeta doesn't like that Broly's got more potential than Prince Vegeta. Something else different too is that goes a little into the backstory of Frieza gaining power over the Saiyans. King Cold's in the movie, and apparently he is retiring, and he's giving dominion over all the planets that he controls over to Frieza. Something else that changes too is the scouters were no longer invented by the Tuffles. Apparently, the Saiyans had like scouter scopes that they used to sense people's power. Sorry, I was drawing a blank. And then Frieza shows up, and whenever he introduces himself to the Saiyans, he's like, "Oh yeah, I have scouters too, and I've upgraded their design, and now they have radios built into them and all that too." So that's how those come to be in this new version. I mean, I don't know what's gonna be retconned or considered canon or what now. Talk a little about the animation. I'm not so technical of a Dragon Ball fan that I'm like, "Oh, I gotta find out who the supervising video animator is or who made the score and all that." But the animation on it's pretty neat, considering what we've seen in the past. It's not always as sharp as what you would see in Dragon Ball Super or Z, but the cool thing about that is there's a softness that makes it kind of look like Dragon Ball, the original series. There's a few scenes where Bulma is in it, and she's wearing some kind of hat, and whenever you look at her, it's very reminiscent of Dragon Ball. The music I actually thought was pretty lackluster. I thought the music from Dragon Ball Super, just its basic music, was better than anything in the Broly movie. Let's see, anything else here? There is humor all throughout the movie. Some of it better than other parts of it. But, particularly whenever it comes to the Dragon Balls, there's a fair amount of humor, and I'll let you guys find all that out. And it's also hilarious, the way that Frieza comes into the fight with Broly. But Broly's form, about to say, also is different. Whenever he turns into a Super Saiyan, he doesn't turn into a giant, Hulk with a chest that's like, 70 inches, and then his biceps are like 20 inches. Whenever Broly transforms in this, he gets bigger, but his form also maintains its size. So everything is actually in a decent proportion, as opposed to the original Broly movies. One other little thing that I'm gonna throw in too, I just remembered it, was the differences in power between Goku and Vegeta in this movie are ridiculous. I mean, I've never particularly liked Vegeta, but Goku in his base form in this movie is stronger than Super Saiyan God Vegeta. And I don't even mean Super Saiyan Blue. I mean, literally, when Vegeta turns Super Saiyan God and fights Broly, he has like a hard time of it after a while. And then Goku's like, oh, hey, it's my turn, and typical Goku fashion. And whenever Goku takes control of the fight, well, not takes control, whenever Goku jumps into the fight, he's doing better than Vegeta did in his Super Saiyan God form. And to me, that was ridiculous. But anyway, I didn't want to ruin a whole lot for you guys, just wanted to tell you what was different and what to expect when you see it. Do I recommend seeing it? Yeah, definitely. It's a cool movie all in all, but it just went that odd path of changing things that we were already used to. The facts that Toriyama established before he was like, oh no, we're gonna change this to that and this to that. But anyway, hope you guys get to see it and y'all enjoy it.